In this lesson, we're going to be doing Listen to the Music by the Doobie Brothers.
This is the method that I use to successfully chart out and arrange a song that I'm trying to duplicate on the Trio Plus. So what I try to do is listen to the MP3, the original, and chart out the intro, the verses, verse one, verse two, the chorus, back to the intro again, and then verse three, verse four, a chorus, a break, and then the chorus outro.
After I've done an arrangement by listening to the MP3 and figuring out how many measures are in the intro, how many measures are in verse one, verse two, chorus, verse three, verse four, the chorus and the outro, then I'll be able to think about how I'm going to input that into the five tracks that are available in the Trio Plus.
Once I get an understanding of the arrangement, I try to find commonalities because, as you know, in the Trio Plus, there's only five tracks that you can record into the unit for one song. So I look for commonalities. So in this case, what I did is I found that the intro plus the two verses equaled 22 measures, and the intro and verse three and four were identical. So I, off the bat, know that I could put this onto one track and use that one track that I assigned this to for both verse one and verse two, and verse three and verse four. This helps me economize my tracks because, again, you only have five tracks that you can work with to build a song on the Trio Plus.
Every time I do a song into the Trio Plus, I Google the beats per minute, and it's very easy to do. And in this case, listen to the music by the Doobie Brothers is a 106 beats per minute. Okay, I'm gonna arm the Trio Plus. I have no echo on my guitar, and the beats per minute is a solid 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that input came out rather well. I'm going to lay down a foundational rhythm. I'm going to put a little effects on my guitar, and I'm going to arm the looper, and I'm going to give myself a click track, and I'm just going to do a simple foundational rhythm. Again, I've made that rhythm intentionally very simple for a foundation. I'm going to do the Tom Johnston thing by doing that hammer-on on the 9th fret. Let's see how it sounds. that sounds pretty good to me. Okay, so I'm gonna do the chorus, and I'm gonna try to do it the simple way, just using simple chords, simple strums. I'm gonna arm the machine, and I'm gonna give myself a click track. Chorus. I have a click track ready to go, and here we go. Let's give a listen to the chorus with my foundational rhythm guitar, and this is how it might sound live, I'm hoping. With the song, I'm also going to check continuity, so I'm going to put it in song mode just quickly, and I'm going to do the first verse, and I'm going to do the chorus, and that's it. And let's see what that sounds like. I'm going to give myself a click track so I can get into this. 2, 3, 4. Checking it out, it sounds like doable. Again, I'm going to try to play this with a vocalist, and I already have a rhythm guitarist below me. Track for the verse, we've created a track for the chorus, And now we're going to create a track for the bridge. Before I begin, I'm going to pre-select the country genre, and I'm going to be putting it on style number 5. Okay, the bridge is going to go into track number 4, and it's ready to record. I'm going to arm track 4, and we're going to begin. 1, 2, 3, 4. Should work. I'm going to actually be putting on my tremolo, and I'm going to overdub and arm the loop. And the reason why I'm going to do the tremolo is if I'm playing this in a live situation, I want to get the core rhythm to have that good sounding tremolo. So here we go. I'm going to arm the looper. I'm going to have a click track here to lead me in. And here we go. Sounds pretty good to me. And over the bridge, in the original composition that the Doobie Brothers do, there's a little bit of a lead pass. So it's going to sound something like this. Sounds pretty good to me.
When going into song mode, what I try to do is organize myself so I know exactly which tracks to choose while I'm in song mode doing the arrangement. So on this side now, what I have is the verse is in number 1, and it's going to be just pressed one time. And then the chorus is track number 2. And then verse 3 and 4 are going to be track 1 again, pressed one time. And then the chorus is again in track 2, pressed one time. The bridge is going to be in track 3. Then the chorus going to the outro and the solo is track 2. And I'm going to do that twice. So the vocals will be one time through the harmonies. And then the lead solo out. And then the ending is in track number 5, and it's one time.
Thank you. guys got some good information out of this tutorial. I'm trying to put songs together with the Trio Plus, not just jams, but full complete songs. And so hopefully this is going to give you some information to do your next song. Thanks very much for listening. I really appreciate it. Bye-bye.